we've come to that part of the show where we're going to show you a NOFX interview and then playing live right here from the London Astoria.
So till next week, rock hard, rock heavy, rock pogo in a punk pipe style.
I'm cold, Crusher.
Oh, shut up.
We've been playing for around 11 years. Started in Hollywood, we were all 16 years old.
That makes us old, figure it out.
And just been playing punk rock for a long time. And wow, now it's popular.
Why do you think that is, that it suddenly just got so sold?
Well, it's great. It's really good music. It just took a long time. But it's not a passing phase, I don't think.
You don't think so?
Like speed metal.
I don't know. I think it might be a passing phase.
Sort of. It's good music. It's got good melody.
Breathe. And the song's off.
We can't control who listens to us, but we don't have to change our music to try to get people to listen to us.
And when you're on MTV, you know, you just make it a big commercial of yourself. It's just like a TV commercial. And then everyone knows that one song, and then you have to keep playing that song. You know, who wants that? You know, Billy Joe from Green Day, he can't go out. He can't hang out in his neighborhood. He just gets mobbed wherever he goes, and he hates it. You know, I don't think that's very fun.
Does it help as well being on, like, a small label that it keeps things, like, in perspective? It doesn't.
Yeah, they do what we want. Like, we made a video, and MTV called and asked to play it, and we told them we don't want to be played, and the label backed us up. You know, I'm sure Geffen would say, like, no, we're pushing it. People made fun of my jacket the other day. Some bus driver.
Did he?
Yeah.
What a jerk.
Like, what are you wearing, a suitcase?
What about live tonight? Is your knee all right? I'm just looking at
you. Yeah, that cool scar I got. Yeah, I'm okay. I'm okay now. So I'm snowboarding and all that kind of stuff.
So it's going to be another mental show.
Mental.
Yeah. We have a lot of friends who will be there, so hopefully we'll be real drunk.
So why is it only one off?
Why is what?
Why is it only a one off thing? Like in Britain? A date thing?
I don't know.
We just toured here 6 months ago and did six shows. And this tour is only a month long. We didn't play Spain or Italy, so we're just doing Spain and Italy mostly. So everyone said we should do one show here. And we like it here.
What do you like about Britain?
Nice people. Everybody's really nice.
And besides that, they speak English.
A bunch of diamond geezers.
You know, Europeans, you know. They don't speak English very well. I don't know what their problem is. I think it's quite rude. We come to their country to play, and they don't have the decency to learn English.
Wow.
Spent 15 years, getting loaded, 15 years to his liver exploding. Now what's Bob gonna do, now that he can't drink? The doctor said, what you been thinking about? Bob said, that's the point, I wanna think about nothing. Yeah, I gotta do something.
Yeah.
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
It's me, Dastardly Dennis. Would I feel ever so cosmopolitan? I'm in Croydon, dears. Pearlie's down there. I've always fancied being a Pearlie Queen, or do I mean King? Mind you, I've got to be careful, because I'm calling on one of his representatives. He appears on telly, so he can't be all good. I've been asked to call by his friends of the Oasis Trust to administer him a little sucker. He does not know I'm calling. Steve Chalk.
Yeah?
Friends of the Oasis Trust have asked me to call. Yeah. You know the friends? You know them. Obviously, you work with them, yes.
Yeah.
I'm Dennis Curtis. Dennis Curtis. I do cooking and things like that.
Yeah.
And they've said that you wouldn't mind me coming round here and cooking you a little supper. Not of the Da Vinci kind. They said you'll welcome me and show me the way to your kitchen. Yes, yeah. Oh, I can see it.
Yeah,
what's in here?
It's down here.
Oh, lovely. Oh, that's the family. Hello.
Yeah,
how are you? Now the kitchen. Where is the kitchen? Dennis Curtis. D-E-N. You must have seen me. You must know me.
Yeah.
You're on telly often yourself. What a lovely show. It's beautiful and all the lovely things up there and so on. I adore the neat kitchen. Now, I want a gander in your gelato box. Bountiful. Oh, garden peas. They should be in the freezer, you know. Cream and butter. Oh, hardly sackcloth and ashes, dears.
Oh, we've got loads of those, but we'll keep them upstairs, actually. The fridge is a bad place for them.
Now, I think from those ingredients, I'll make you a fresh-tasting pea soup without a trace of ham in it. In fact, the only ham will be in my performance. Now, for that, I'm going to need 2.5 pints of water. Now, Steve, get on with chopping up these onions.
Yeah, like this?
Yeah, absolutely perfect. Oh, that's very, very, very good. Tell me, what do you do? Are you sort of kind of a dilettante, or are you a real man of God, or what?
Well, I do a little bit of writing and television and radio, but actually my real job is to work for the Oasis Trust, which I started.
Oh, those people who sent me that.
That's right. They're really kind to me, because what we do is we work with homeless young people in London and in Birmingham and in Bombay in India. We work a little bit in France, and we've got some offices in Africa, in Tanzania as well. We train youth workers. We run a medical centre, actually, right here in London, and we look after people's feet and give them new clothes, showers, baths, medical services. We've got a nurse, all sorts of things.
Well, Christianity is proper sense, then. It's lovely. Yeah. But you enjoy all the other little bits and pieces, nearly finished those.
Yeah, I think I've done it,
Now, I have the same enthusiasm, actually. Once I get on with the cooking, I'm like an organ with all its stops pulled out. Now, I'm going to put these herbs in. In goes the mint to the water. In goes the parsley to the water. In goes the sugar to the water, and let's scoop up your onions. They can go in as well. Come on, help me. Push them in.
Right, okay.
Thank you, dear. Last little lot in, they can go.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Now, all I need is 2 pounds of peas. The great thing about this soup, Steve, is that you use frozen peas. You don't have to pot them. My gosh, yesterday it was so cold I could hardly get me bus pass out. I wonder if he uses antifreeze in his organ. Now, they're all going to cook together for 20 minutes. A quick blend in here with butter. I thought she wore a deaf aid. Well, I've sieved the soup. Get rid of that, Steve, would you, dear?
Okay, over here.
I'll add a little salt, not too much.
Yeah.
A good grinding of pepper, and you pour in that cream.
I'll put this in right
there,
like that.
Thank you very much. And that'll all heat through gently whilst we have a chat. I was fascinated by what you said earlier, but how did it all start?
Well, when I was 14, I started going along to a church, basically because there was a girl that was a real cracker. I fancied her. And I would have gone anywhere for her, and she happened to go to church. And one Sunday, as I was sitting there, it suddenly dawned on me that if God was God, I needed to live my whole life for him. And for me, that meant particularly caring for the poor and the homeless, but a whole number of other things as well. And so at the age of 14, I started going up on the streets of London, underneath the arches.
Billiard Street.
Yeah, that's right. And every Friday night, my mum and dad, my mum would make some sandwiches and some soup, and I'd take it up, and I'd get to know a lot of these people who were homeless. And actually, I watched a lot of them die. I'd turn up on a particular Friday, and I'd say, well, where's Jeff? And they say, well, he died during last week. He was found on a park bench. And at that age, I decided that when I was older, part of being a Christian for me, part of what God wanted me to do, was set up a hostel for homeless kids. So we set one up in London, then another one, and then, you know, the whole thing's gone worldwide from there.
And that's how your trust started.
It is.
Thank you. It's a remarkable story. Now, let's have a little taste.
Is that good?
Mmm. Lovely. Ready to serve. Here we are. Steve's pea soup. Now, you obviously hearken to your voice. I've got a voice which I constantly try to avoid. Voice!
And you've failed again, Mr. Curtis. And to make Steve's pea soup, pour 2.5 pints of water into a saucepan, add 2 pounds of frozen peas, 2 bunches of cleaned and chopped spring onions, 1 dessert spoon of sugar, some mint and parsley, and simmer for 20 minutes. Liquidize with 3.5 ounces of butter, and then sieve back into the saucepan. Add 4 tablespoons of cream, reheat, season and serve, avec croutons.
I saw it. I was tempted. I took it. I shouldn't have. I used it.
Dennis, what was it? You can tell me.
It was unforgivable. I used margarine instead of butter in my puff pastry.
Camera one, and cue the opening titles.